Well, so we were trying to use the Mindstorm and the microbit to solve air pollution.
We were trying to solve from weeds growing in unexpected places.
We learned how to code and how to program lots of robots and to code for a microbit.
We enjoyed the most that it was very fun to always have to solve the problem, and then it feels very good when it starts to work.
The impact on the students, I feel like the students really gained a lot out of it, and as I was talking to the students, they said they hadn't seen anything like this before and they didn't even know what STEM was, and for them to understand that STEM all works together, science, technology, engineering and maths, that's already a big step from them, starting from just English and maths to like incorporating all four areas together.
Yeah, the impact on the students has been powerful. They've had to assess their failures on their way to success. It's been a huge growth in STEM participation.
I'd like to learn more advanced codes with the microbit, because when we did it was very simple, and it would be cool if we could have it to send like a radio to Kazi to tell her off a computer or something like that, yeah.
I think the kids are more inclined to using STEM now because they know how to code, how to play with Mindstorms, and yeah, and they find it a lot of fun.
I'd really like to learn more about engineering. I seem to be good at that one.
I kept asking them, would you do this again? And they'd say, yeah.
I'd like to learn a bit more about the Mindstorms and how they work, as well as coding and being able to create different things about them. Thank you.